so that was about 74 when I started, and I've got the 8-watt GX24 lamp in there. That's a pretty decent amount of light right there. That is pretty bright, so I'll let this run for a while. It is warming up, so I want to keep an eye on this, see what kind of temperature we get to. Okay, so I've had this 8-watt GX24 lamp running for about a half hour, and it looks like it's topping out around 120 Fahrenheit. Now the watt meter is showing about 12 watts, 12 or 13, but this meter tends to read about 5 watts high at the very low end. I think the power is probably what they specify is 8 watts, and you can really tell by the temperature. It's a little warmer than skin temperature, but it's not like the CFL. It was about 3 seconds. I could touch there, 1, 2, and then ouch, it was hot. Okay, so the actual lamp gets a little bit hotter. It was about 160 when I first took the cover off. It looks like that's about the hottest just along the top there. So yeah, it gets a little bit hot, but nowhere near as hot. I mean, the CFL was 190 on the outside of the plastic. And they do have a 5,000 and 3,000 Kelvin in the GX24. If you go to the G24, they have about 4 different color temps. In the GX24, there's a choice of 2, and this seems to be the only company that makes a GX24 compatible LED. So that's the reason I went to this as another option, is I made a Philips GX24 lamp. So I'll try that one next. Okay, so I've left this Philips 10.5-watt bulb run. It's been about 40 minutes, and it's only up to 116 minutes. So it's about the same temperature as the Hero LED bulb, so that's pretty promising. Yeah, I think I may just put a couple little holes, like a hole here on each side, and then maybe put some couple little holes up here at the top. That way it'll pull air kind of in from here and out over the bulb a little bit. And just to look at the watts over here, so we're at about, this says 14. Again, if we take off roughly 4 or 5 watts, seems like that bulb is, you know, in the 10 watt range like they advertise. So I pull the cover off and I'll try to get a heat gun reading just real quick before it cools off. Okay, yeah, this bulb does get a little bit hotter. That's like it was around 180. Yeah, so that's, it was up around 80 Celsius. Yeah, maybe I'll drill a couple of holes and then I'll rerun this temperature test. Anyway, we'll touch base when we get the next step done here. So we'll catch you later then. Thanks for watching.